What's up, guys? Hey, it's John. Welcome back. So this one I didn't do an intro on because this is a more serious, well, this video gets deep. Let me explain. I got an email, well, question from one of you guys or girls or whatever, and it said, John, do you think women are evil? You make several references to different religions talking about the fact that, well, you know, whatever. That they need to be kind of, because they could potentially have a problem to, you know, be problematic, we'll say. That's safe. Let me explain. This is going to get deep. Now, I do want to tell you guys, I'm going to just give you the facts. You can make up your own mind. This is present in many different religions. I'm going to touch on that. Don't argue with me in the chat. I'm not looking to have a discussion with anyone about this. I'm going to tell you what I know, and I've read, like I said, Bible's there, Quran, Judaism, Kabbalah. I'll prove myself and what I'm thinking about. You guys can take it and run with it if you want to. It's not going to get boring crazy, but I want you to, if you're Muslim, I want you to listen. We're going to talk a little bit about how it all comes together. Don't worry. But I want you guys to put your red pill thinking hat on and follow along with me. I know you all know the basis of the Christianity with the Adam and the Eve and the garden and the snake. Just listen. If you want to stick around, cool. If not, catch me on the next video. I'll talk about some, what we talk about on another video. But if you listen to this, I want you to think about it from a red pill lens and female nature lens. It's about to get deep, boys. Come on. All right, so let's pull this up here. The question was, do I think women are evil? Let me get this on the right tab and catch up here because I've got so much going on at once. All right. Where are we? Let's start here with Samael. All right, so do you guys know who Samael is? No? Okay, let's talk for a quick second then. All right, so Samael was an angel in heaven with God and the Lord. And basically what happens is Samael went against the Lord. There's a lot of different things, but we'll talk about something in a minute. You can put two and two together for yourself. It'll make a lot of sense. But essentially, Samael put himself first and challenged the Lord. That was a sin because it's, you know, let me explain. Who was Samael? Well, he was cast out of heaven, carried by the archangel Michael to hell. He changed his name in defiance of and became Lucifer, Satan. You got it. All right, so we're caught up there. He also was made by God and is a mirror of, it was with Lilith as a mirror of Azrael. In Azrael in the Muslim faith, it has a different name in Christianity, but it's essentially the farrier of souls, the angel of death, okay? The farrier of souls between their body and getting them back to God. In Muslim culture, it's to Allah. He ferries the souls back. We're all still on the same page here. Let's talk about this for a moment. When I mentioned Lilith, who was Lilith, guys? Now you might say, well, that's in the Judaism faiths. Christianity doesn't talk about that. Well, Christianity may not talk about it for a very good reason, but I'm going to let you make up your mind yourselves. I'm just going to connect some dots here, what I see. Going through all the different texts of all the different. According to traditional, Samael is king of all demons, angel of death, husband of the demonic Lilith. Husband? Satan had Lucifer, had a wife? Isn't that interesting, guys? So, and the Archangel of Michael, angel, yep. Got all that. So, think about that. Let's look here. Who is Lucifer's first wife? The Lilith. Oh, man. Let's see here. Lilith appears. She is the ex-wife, first wife of Adam, the first human. And Lilith is the wife of Lucifer, Samael. Are y'all connecting any dots yet? There should be bells and red pill things going off in your brain. Even if you're not religious, just stay with me. Just storyline alone. Do you see anything here? Lilith. Okay. She is the ex-wife, first wife of Adam, the first human, wife of Lucifer. We all see that, right? All right. Stay with me. We're going to get deep. Wow. I don't know where I decided to put this cut in and edit this in, but I left out some stuff I wanted to share with you guys. I figure it's definitely worth, well, I got to bring it up and show you just so you have all the information and we can tie this together as far as are women evil or not. It's not up to me to say. I mean, I'm just showing you what all the religions seem to think about this subject, but let's dive back in. Let me make sure. Okay, we're here. All right, pay attention. We're going to get back to what I'm saying in a minute, but this is necessary to bring it all together. So look here. Look at what this says here, guys. Nephilim. All right. You may not know what a Nephilim is, but the Nephilim. Arguably, we humans would be Nephilim if you believe that our father is God and we are, you know, our mother is our mother. And it's listen. The Nephilim were on Earth in those days, blah, 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 blah. When the sons of God went into the daughters of human, Nephilim were born. Supposedly us, if you believe that. Again, what does it say? Sons of God, Adam. We know this. Well, okay, let's move on. Now, a couple of you were like, hey, what about, are you talking about the Nephilim and Diablo? Not no, because that's spelled differently, but maybe it's spelled differently so that the names could be changed to protect the innocent or whatever. But since you brought up Diablo, not to nerd out on you, I want you to read this. What does this say? The Nephilim from Diablo. The Nephilim are humanity's forebears, right? The offspring of an angel and a demon. What's that mean? If Samael was an angel before he fell from heaven, who was the demon? Was it his wife Lilith? I know, guys. Anyways, let's get back into, I'll cut this, I'll put this in. You guys that are sticking through, y'all are some champs, I gotta tell you. I know religion's a touchy subject, that's why I don't ever talk about it, but thank you to everyone that is listening. Appreciate it. Back to the video. Now here we are, this is, what's the title of this here? Samael and Lilith and the concept of evil in early Kabbal. You know, you can cut the end of the sentence off. That's Jewish, you know, Judaism and the Kabbal. I mean, but what does it say? Samael and Lilith. So we're still talking about the same people, Christian religion here and Judaism, still referencing the same people, the concept of evil. Those two names in Judaism are related with the concept of evil in and of itself. I know some of you red pill guys right now are making some connections. Let's continue here. I just put this together for y'all to kind of show you a little bit. So here we are. Look what I highlighted. Whoops, there it is. Did Adam have two wives? What? Lilith and Eve, wives of Adam. Hey, look, I know I'm not trying to light any fires or upset anybody. I'm just, if all of the religions make certain references to certain people, whether it be pronounced differently in a different language or not, you guys still with me, right? Lilith and Eve, both wives of Adam. Did y'all know Adam had two wives? Christianity doesn't talk about that very much. Judaism mentions it. Some other people mentioned it. I don't want to get into too many names because there's a lot of touchy feelings between the two. So let's just, all right, we're still going down the rabbit hole, guys. Of course, there's Azrael. I talked about him a little earlier. The, angel of death. Islam makes reference to this. Christian. So we all talking about the same people here. Now, again, in the Bible, it doesn't go into much about a Lilith, though. There's nothing in there really about that. It's Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve. And Adam and Eve, what does it say about Adam and Eve? She was tempted in the garden. Who was she tempted by? Do y'all remember? Was it a snake? I think it was a snake, right? Let's look at this right here. What does this say? In the Jewish faith, the Zohan, guys, I don't know if you know this or not, is the snake becomes the symbol of Lilith. What? Who tempted Eve in the garden? What does that say? The Zohar, I'm sorry, I don't know why I said Zohan. The Zohar is a Jewish, you know, Judaism, it's lore, it's like the Kabbalah, it's stories of, but what does it say? In there, it says the snake has become the symbol of Lilith. So in the Bible, in the garden, can we assume that the snake could be this Lilith, supposed the other wife of Adam? That, again, the Bible makes no mention of a first wife. It's Adam and Eve. That's all we know about, really. I know some of y'all are like, wait a minute. I know. We never hear much about Lucifer having a wife or anything like that. We know that he was cast to hell. He gave up his name of Samael in defiance and adopted the name Lucifer or became the Lucifer. But you don't ever hear about his wife Lilith. What happened to her? Well, many people throughout theology speculate that Lilith still roams the earth today and can be seen in the mirror of so many modern women. The spirit of Lilith. Guys, this is an interesting story, but I've just made several connections that I hope you can kind of, again, don't be in my comments mad at me and John, I just showed you different religions all talking about some of the exact same people. I know our Bible, this version of it will say, there's no reference to Lilith in Christianity, okay? But then again, in the South in the old days, if you got pregnant, if you were a single mother or whatever, they shipped you up to Chicago to have the baby. There was no mention of that shit either. So do your own math, come to your own conclusions. I don't know what to tell you, but if I'm honest with what I've read in reading Bibles and, like I said, all kinds of different texts and making my own little connections in the dots, it seems like if women are indeed offshoots of Eve, then indeed there's a, Lilith, okay, and Samael were supposedly created by God as a mirror, dark mirror of Azrael. And Azrael was the good farrier, or angel of death, bringing the souls back to God. But they were the ones taking the souls away from God if they were the dark mirror. Samael, who became Lucifer, and Lilith. Now again, from a religious standpoint, believe what you want. Believe whatever you want. But all of that I just told you checks out. And if that's the case, you do what you want with that information. Anyways, I don't do many religious videos. Don't get mad at me. Don't unsubscribe. I'm not going to make it full of religious videos. Y'all do what you want. But this is what I know. And, you know, from a red pill standpoint, you kind of have to be like, oh, wait a minute. If he had two wives and then back then, and that even Judaism actually refers to Samael, Lucifer, and his wife Lilith as the epitome of evil. It's in the Kabbalah. Anyways, it's crazy. Anyways, I'm gone with John. I know. Save your comments unless they're positive. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. We'll see you later. I'm going to go watch the Alabama game. Peace and roll tide.